Hey everyone, and welcome back to Mesh Lab. Today, we're exploring subdivision modeling, a game-changing workflow in 3D art. In this video, I'll break down what it is, why it's essential, and how you can use it to create professional-looking 3D models. Whether you're new to 3D or just looking to sharpen your skills, this is the perfect place to start. So let's get started. Subdivision modeling is a workflow where a low-poly base mesh can be refined into a smoother, more detailed version by adding more geometry and smoothing out sharp edges. It's a technique you'll use across industries, and it is done simply by subdividing your mesh to view it at its highest quality. Subdivision modeling is essential because it allows you to create high-quality, production-ready assets for games, film, and even product design. As we talked about in my hard surface modeling essentials video, no edge in real life is completely sharp, right? And if edges in your scene are left looking like that, they tend to look unrealistic and can bring down the quality of your scene as a whole. To combat this, subdivision is necessary. So let's understand what this workflow is and how to approach it. And to do this, let's start by breaking down what a subdivision preview actually is. Whereas in Blender, you can apply the subdivision modifier to your mesh to view it at its highest fidelity, in Maya, you can do this simply by pressing 3 on your keyboard. This will trigger your object's smooth preview. If you wish to go back to your low poly preview, just press 1. The difference between 1 and 3 is simply a few subdivisions. So basically, what's happening behind the scenes is that every time you press 3, Maya adds 2 subdivisions to your model. Which, if put simply, just means that Maya is selecting your model and going mesh smooth once and mesh smooth again. Now you might wonder, if this is all that's really happening behind the scenes, why not just manually smooth it every time you want to view your model at its highest fidelity? Well, simply put, every time your model is subdivided, every face gets split into 4 faces, and that means that every subdivision adds 4 times more geometry to your model, giving you a crazy number of edges to deal with. Whereas the subdivision preview with 3 gives you all the benefits of having more geometry while still maintaining a manageable, low-poly based topology, making it much, much easier to work with. So let's take this cube for example. If I turn on my smooth preview, it instantly becomes a sphere, which is pretty weird if you think about it. Is the highest form of a cube a sphere? Well, kinda, but also not really. The reason our cube crumbles into a ball is because every time a subdivision is applied, the software calculates and smooths the surface by averaging out the position of all the surrounding geometry. This essentially means that unless you're purposefully adding more supporting edges, your object is going to get smoothed out. The key here is edge flow. Properly placed edges guide how the surface smooths, and this is why good topology is so important in subdivision modeling. So if we wanted this cube to hold up as a cube, all we need to do is add a few edge loops close to the edges that we want to support. This in turn will allow our cube to maintain its hard edges even after subdivision. What you will notice soon is that depending on where you place the supporting edge loops, you can control the highlight of the edge. Lesser distance between edge loops will give you a sharper highlight, and more distance will give you softer ones. But adding supporting edges manually might not always be the best option, because at the end of the day, we're only human. Which means every time you add a supporting edge, it might be a different spacing than the last one, making all your highlights look different and uneven. And that's exactly where bevels come in. By beveling all the edges you want to keep sharp at the same time, you can ensure that all your highlights are exactly how you intended them to be, and are all the same. Whenever you bevel an edge, it gets averaged out and split up into multiple edges to give you a smooth and soft edge. Depending on the amount of segments you add and the fraction that you choose, you can then get the exact highlights that you want. Pairing your bevels with the smooth preview can help you achieve all those perfect highlights and smooth surfaces that can take your model to the next level. But here's the thing, subdivision modeling is not magic. If your base mesh has bad topology, like triangles or n-gons, you'll end up with weird distortions after subdivision. And don't overdo the poly count either. Try to keep it efficient. And there it is. subdivision modeling in a nutshell. If you found this helpful, hit that like button and subscribe for more modeling tips and tutorials. And let me know in the comments, what's the first model you would like to create using this workflow?